Okay, let's take some questions.
Okay, great. Paula writes, can you lose your healing?
Without question, you can lose your healing. I mean, if you start questioning what happened, we've had it over and over again. You know, somebody was healed, they began to walk, they took braces off, and they were moving around, and then somebody said, well, you really shouldn't do that without your braces, and they put the braces on, and bang, the paralysis comes right back. So, yes, you can lose it. You need to continue to walk in the faith that God gives you. Next Amen. Question.
Milton writes, my daughter and her husband are at the point of divorce. I've prayed my heart out to God. I even asked him to give me a feeling of peace to show that he heard my plea. Nothing happens. He has shut the door to my prayer. I don't know what else to do.
I tell you, what you got to do is surrender that child and her husband to the Lord. You can't force somebody. You can't live somebody else's life. You can't live your child's life. I mean, we have to recognize that. They're independent beings, and the fact that she's married, she is now emancipated. She has left her mother's home and is cleaving to her husband. Now they're breaking up. It's a tragedy, but you can pray and ask, but surrender them to the Lord. You're holding on. Let go. Let go and say, God, I'm giving her into your hand. And then let him take it from there. All right.
Yeah, let go and let God. Amazing. All right, Brian writes, my question is on Hebrews 6, 4 through 6. What does it mean if a Christian walks away that he or she can't come back to God? It has been 10 years that I did my thing and I won't run back to him. So if you can shed some light on this, Hebrews.
Here's what it does. For in the case of those who have once been enlightened and have tasted of the heavenly gift and have been made partakers of the Holy Spirit and have tasted the good work of God and the powers of the age to come and then have fallen away, it is impossible to renew them again to repentance. That has to do with apostasy, of turning away from God completely. It doesn't mean you've gone into sin and you're drinking too much or you're sleeping around. It means that you have literally turned your back on God and you counted the covenant of grace an unholy thing. That's what that says. And so I don't think you've done that. So what else? Mm.
Mrs. L. writes, I know a member of the Assemblies of God. This person told me that Jewish people do not worship the same God that we do. Is it really the truth?
I don't know where people get this stuff. Of course, the God of Israel is the God of Jesus. Jesus was a Jew. He was a Jew. And most of the early apostles were Jews. It was a Jewish religion. And he was the Messiah of Israel, and of course, the God. Elohim is Jewish God, but the Lord is Yahweh, Jehovah, Yehovah. It's in Hebrew, the God we have of the Christian faith, Jewish. And we are grafted in as Christians. Okay, what else?
All right, Justin writes, I have a family member who says you need to be immersed to be saved, and if I am baptized any other way, I will go to hell along with everyone else who is not immersed. She has even said a family member on her deathbed will go to hell. Is immersion the only way as far as water baptism?
There's some people who are into these fundamentalist cults who just got an awful lot of misinformation. If what she said was true, then Jesus Christ was wrong on the cross. And I don't think the Son of God made a mistake when he told the thief, this day you'll be with me in paradise. That guy said, remember me when you come into your kingdom. He didn't get baptized in water, and he didn't get immersed. I mean, this is nonsense. Where do you get this stuff? And, you know,
so baptism is our public confession that we are believers.
Well, no, it's more than that. It's if you read the sixth chapter of Romans, it has to do with it's a symbol of death. You're buried with him in baptism, raised in newness of life. So that is the immersion thing, but nevertheless, it is a public confession, as you say, that we've come to the Lord. Paul said, I want you to know that I haven't baptized, but there were a couple. And I don't remember I baptized a couple, but I was here to preach the gospel. If baptism was what was going to save you, then Paul would have baptized every single person he led to the Lord. And he personally said, I didn't. I baptized a few, but I was here to preach the gospel.